Yes, hello. Hi everyone, hello.
Hello.
You seem quite brain, very much in everything. That's good. So, anyway, so sir was talking about one thing, so I'll start from there, right? Okay, before that, how many of us are on Facebook?
Everybody.
Everyone, right? Instagram? Everyone, right? But do you think that there's a very big problem that we are facing with Facebook and Instagram these days? It's a very necessity thing. Now it has become a necessity, but there's a very, very, very big problem that we are facing on Instagram and Facebook. And what is that?
Data privacy.
Data privacy, number one.
More?
A lot of ads. And what I believe is, the worst kind of problem is we can't trust on Facebook, we can't trust on Instagram the kind of content that they're serving us.
That's fake news.
That's what I'm saying. The fake news menace. And that is going on and on. There's no credibility of any content that is being shown to us. Right? So for that, to curb that problem, there's a need for a revolution, right? So for that, I developed Mirror. So how I started, now I'll go step by step. How I started, basically I made a website when I was in college. I made a website, there were some students came to me. Students started posting their news it's a hyper-local platform. Students come, they put news from their own university, from their own cities, from everything. Because see, youth is everywhere and they see everything and there are cameras on the phones and everything. They make news, they send it, they put up on the portal, put up on the website, the people come, use it and everything. All the newspaper, major newspaper come to us, they take the news and everything and they post it, whatever is relevant or not, right? That's how I started. The journey, 2015, 2016, we developed it, then 2000, so yeah, we covered the yoga festival, so it's just, right, and Nitin Gadkari, Kiran Khel, they are all ministers. Then we launched our print edition, right, and then we started distributing the print edition. That was created by the students of that particular university, and by the way, we are in multiple universities. I don't want to name the university, I don't want to give you the count. Well, let's keep that for a personal talk, right? We are in multiple universities, so people develop that newspaper and then distribute it among other students, right? Chuck it. Right, so, okay, we have 45,000 plus views on our website every month, right? It's about 60,000, this could be a little old. Then we have 32,000 likes on our Facebook page. Number two, and it's all verified by Facebook and everything, right? Now the thing that I'm here for, I need an application now. Now what I've been doing since last 3 years, I've been creating team, going to university by university, and now it is very tiring. Number one, it's a very slow process, right? But now I want to create an application. I've already started the development process. It's already through. 50% is already made. I'm sorry, I can bring the APK beta version of it, right? My team is working on it. Now I want the universe application that can automatically make more people join the whole campaign, join the whole, like an application that can, people can just come and, you know, have their content uploaded. So this is some UI UX of it. Right, now some exclusive features, how it is going to be different from other social media platforms. The 10-second news story. You know, suddenly Snapchat came into the market and it became a thing, suddenly. Nobody knew how it just became a thing, but Snapchat became a thing. The only reason because it curbed the problem of fake news, right? The 10-second story, what you do on Snapchat, you can do on our website. Online classes by the university teacher of all around the world, right? If a university is, okay, there's a block and the all the students are connected to each other, university teachers can come there and have their own virtual classes on that university, then note sharing between students. Different kind of students have different kind of notes, and some has amazing notes, some has don't have amazing notes. They can do that here. And yes, how to tackle the fake news problem in this? The answer is very simple, accountability. The answer is very, very simple, accountability. If you have understood what I have told till now, there are a lot of people in that one block in that one city, geographical city, there are a lot of people. What you do is, initially, you put your own team. Initially, my own team is working to validate the whole news, to validate everything. And when you know, okay, this person is putting good news, like for example, they have uploaded 100 articles and they are exactly correct 100 articles, you promote them to become a sub-editor, right? Sub-editor has the authority to edit 100 articles, right? And those 100 articles can go to the editor, and it is all being done by an automated process. No physical contact needed for this, right? Now, the major question comes, how will it curb it? So if you know human psychology a little, let me explain you. Human psychology is very funny. If a human being is put in a structure, it automatically starts developing around that structure, and it just keeps on revolving in that structure. He doesn't think here, he doesn't think there. It just keeps on simply going round and round in that structure. So if you put people in this structure, that's it. They'll be going, they know that they're accountable for the next 100 people who are giving them the editing and everything, so they will do it. So that's how we can solve the fake news problem. So technical things, I'm not a technical guy, I'm sorry, I cannot answer for all this, but you can see. Thank you, that's all. Thank you so much. Question for him.